From spring break. It's Gavin, and I'm here with Mr. Hunt, and he's going to talk about state testing.
Hi, Matterbrook. Good morning. It's great to see everybody. Yes, state testing is coming up, and we want to give you a few friendly reminders, but first, we're going to talk about the purpose of the test. Why are we taking this test? Well, the main reason is it's going to give us a nice evaluation on how you're doing in your academic courses. And the second reason we take this test is it also gives us an evaluation on how we're doing as a school site. Now, some friendly reminders how to be successful on this test. Well, the testing schedule is going to change, which has been sent home to all the families here in Meadowbrook. You will have a period in the morning that is 161 minutes that is allocated for the test. So come ready every morning, fresh, fired up, prepared, and ready to go to do your best. I mentioned earlier, come prepared. Well, what does that mean? You need to bring the following items. Your Chromebook device, which is fully charged. Also, have your power cord charger with you in your backpack, so that way if your battery runs low, you are prepared with your charger. Next, and very important, absolutely no cell phones or smartwatches or any personal tech devices that could impact our testing security. This is taken very seriously, so do not bring your phone or your smartwatch into the testing environment at any point during our testing season. Last, you are allowed to use headphones during the testing. So if you'd like to bring your own personal headphones, you may do so. Please make sure after testing that those are put away so that way they don't get taken in another class if you have them out during instruction. Last and most important, Meadowbrook, is we believe in you. You're gonna do your best. Come ready, you're gonna rock it.
And that was Mr. Hunt.
That was Mr. Hunt. See you. Yeah.
Bella?
What's this all for?
It's April 21st.
What's April 21st?
National Tea Day. ASB is going to be handing out tea in the back patio of room 508 from 720 to 730.
So if I get there from 720 to 730, how much will it cost?
It's completely free.
No way.
I know, right?
Cookies are ready. Don't touch the cookies. They're hot.
Don't forget to come to my tea party from 720 to 730 in the back patio of room 508 on April 21st, or National Tea Day. Just remember that cookies are not included. Can't wait to see you there.
Good morning, Mutterbook. This is Dale McWilliams with our first annual paper tournament. First annual paper airplane tournament. Our top four contestants will compete in the semifinals. The two winners will participate in a prize card drawing and then move up to the finals where they will compete for one final chance to choose a prize card. Who will win?
What you're gonna need to do is use the paper given to make paper airplanes. Whosoever plane flies the furthest wins. So, are you guys ready?
Let's go!
Yes!
3, 2, 1, go! The winner goes to Alex! Woo! Congratulations on winning! Since you won, you can pick a pride card!
Denise Diaz.
Oh, I know her!
3, 2, 1, go!
Yes!
Yes, you are! The winner is Roman! Woo! Congratulations on winning! Since you won, please pick a pride card.
All right. The second winner is Adriana Santiago Rojas.
Congratulations on making it to the finals. This time, you'll get to use a big piece of paper. Woo! And the winner goes to Roman! Congratulations on winning the finals.
Thank you.
How do you feel?
I feel great. It was too easy.
Since you won, you can pick the last pride card.
It's gonna be Gavin. I got Emily Wildens.
For the three winners who won the pride cards, remember to pick up your prize in the office in room 104 from Mr. Hunt.
For those of you who didn't make it in, you'll be put into the Pizza with Friends drawing at the end of the trimester. Bye, Meadowbrook!
Good morning, Meadowbrook. This is Alyssa with a few words of wisdom. There's an ancient text that reads, "There are no riches above a sound body. All the riches in the world mean nothing if you don't have a good health and self-well-being." Every day, we are faced with choices that affect our health and our bodies, such as, do I go out and ride my bike this afternoon, or do I sit here and play with my 20th video game? Do I eat the whole bag of Oreo cookies, or do I eat just two? Do I get some sleep, or do I stay up all night and watch TV? Do I poison my body with drugs, or do I nurture my body with good food? Walt Whitman says, "If anything is sacred, the human body is sacred." One definition for the word sacred is treated with the highest respect. Today, ask yourself if you're treating your body with the respect it deserves. You'll be a richer person for it. With something to think about, this is Alyssa. Make it a great day or not, the choice is yours.
Sports equipment is now available at the Mustang Market on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. Make sure to get it.
So let's go to the Mustang Market.
If you have any ideas, make sure to leave your ideas in the ASB suggestion box in room 508.
Moves.
You can. Auditions will be held 18th through the 22nd, which is the week after spring break, and the actual talent show will be on the 26th through 27th during year period lunch.
Yes, this is what I've been waiting for.
Let's practice.
This is Wyatt
and Theo
with the word up. The first word is administration.
The definition of administration is the people who manage a company or an institution.
The administration of Meadowbrook can be found at the office.
The second word is effect.
The definition of effect is to do something that produces a change in someone or something.
Yeah.
Ryan being in the game greatly affected the outcome of the match.
That was Pia.
And Wyatt.
With the word up.
It's time to wake up, people. This one goes out to teachers.
Teachers and students.
It's time to get our learn on. And we got a lot to learn, too.
I don't know it all, but I know a few things.
Science. You hear? You take up space, you matter.
It's just science, man.
Life is school, and you gotta show up.
You can't just sleep in. You can't be late. And you can't just hang out in the bathroom, that's gross.
It's like Walt Whitman said, YOLO. Except he didn't say that,
but you would know that if you would read a book, baby. Seriously, read a book, any book except the vampire ones.
If their teacher inspires you, let them know. This is for teachers everywhere, so share it with them.
We gotta make the world awesome.
Somebody's learning from you. I'm out.
This is a reminder for teachers and students that the mindful moment will be following the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Face the flag, put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.